Hey, welcome to CG Hacks. I'm Dustin Valkema, and today we're talking about how to use Gobo Textures in Cinema 4D and Redshift to add a bit of depth and mood to your lighting. It's quite a simple process. I'll see you in Cinema 4D. All right, we're in Cinema 4D with the Redshift render view running. We have a very simple studio setup. It's a room with two walls and a floor, and I've got a Redshift dome light that is adding a nice bit of ambient lighting to the scene. And this is how I like to get started with my lighting personally. I like to get my ambient shadows or my ambient lighting done before I start to introduce other types of light into the environment. When it comes to gobos, there are two different types of lights here that I like to use. In Redshift, it's the spotlight and the area light. So we're going to start with the spotlight. I've got one in my scene already pointing down at the chair. We'll turn that on and immediately we can see the spotlight's on. It looks pretty good. I've already adjusted the exposure and the intensity just a bit here. The important part is that we just have a spotlight. There is no texture to it. It does add a bit more drama to the scene, but it's not really giving us a cinematic style feel as if maybe this light is coming from a window or something of that nature. So the way that we would do this is by inputting a gobo texture into the texture slot here under the color dropdown in the attribute manager for this light. So we need to find a gobo. Now our Gobo's Textures from CG Hacks comes with four different categories: the abstract, liquid, nature, and windows and blinds. You can check out more details in the link in the description if you're interested. Right now we're just going to pop into windows and blinds, and we're going to find a texture that's going to work well for this. Now I feel like we can use the texture 16 here. This is going to give us a pretty good breakup. Just look like there's some blinds in here. We can drag this texture directly into the texture input in the attribute manager, and we'll see that that now takes effect. So immediately we can see the effect that we have. We have our window light in the scene, but we're also noticing that we have this odd circular fall off here from the light. And so this may not be exactly what we want. So there are certain times like this where I may use a gobo that is coming through a spotlight for something like nature and environments where I want little pockets of light, and it doesn't really matter if there's a fall off because there's no need for a hard edge like you might have with a window. So this is how you use it with a spotlight. Simply plug in the texture and it's going to work. Let's turn off the spotlight and turn on our area light. So I like the area lights because you can actually control the way that this light is going to spread across your scene. So with the area light on by itself, again, I've already adjusted the intensity and so on for the scale of the light in the scene. We can already see that there's a really nice fall off to this light. It's a pretty light, may use this for something like a product render or similar, but if we want to get a little bit more moody and dramatic, it's going to be a similar process to the spotlight with a couple tweaks. So first of all, if you've never done it before, we're just going to copy the file path from the other light into this one so we don't have to go back out. We already know that we want a window, so we can copy our file path from the spotlight and then paste this directly into the texture for our area light. Now immediately we're going to see that light fall off change, and the quality of light has changed, and that's because now we have a texture here, but this is still being spread out, as is the nature of area lights. So what we're going to need to do is head down in our attribute manager all the way down to the shape section, and this is where the magic happens. We can take our spread and drop that all the way down to zero. Now this is what we would expect to see from something like windows. We see the edges of the window. We don't have an odd circular fall off that we were getting with the spotlight. This is looking a lot more dramatic and a lot better for this scene. Now we can simply rotate the light. There we go. Maybe something like this. And if we wanted, we can turn the light in any direction. And this is going to give us the representation of having sunlight coming through the window. And it's going to warp and look the way that we would expect it to. When I'm dealing with lights, I like to adjust the color or the temperature of that light to make sense in my scene. So currently we have our modes set to color. We can actually set this down to color and temperature so that now with the white color plugged in, we can simply adjust the temperature of this light. Now we can take our temperature quite down. We can get really warm with this and we can see we have something more, maybe like a sunset-ish vibe to this. So 5200 Kelvin looks nice. We have a bit more warmth in the scene. The environment's looking good. And now with the area light settings that we have in the shape parameters, we can start to make some adjustments. So if we want this light to be a bit more spread out and diffused, it's as easy as raising the spread value. And we can already see the adjustments that this is making to the scene. So this is one way that I like to work with it. The area shape is pretty cool. If we maybe head to disk, we'll see something change. Take our spread all the way down to zero again here. This will help us out a little bit. There we go. And now with that spread at zero and we're using a disk, let's shrink this down and rotate it towards the wall and see what happens. At this point, we can see that this is very similar to what we were getting with the spotlight that we had, where we're getting some of the rounding on those edges. And we can actually use this to create pretty interesting results just using the area light rather than using the spotlight as well. So there are reasons and times to use one or the other, but I thought that you may want to know that you can mimic the very similar results from the spotlight with the area light simply by using the spread adjustments and changing the shape of your light. Now we'll head back to rectangle, position this just a little bit better here, and there we go. Now the cool part about the area lights is that we can very easily control the size of our window, and we can make this quite large in the scene if we want to have big cascading windows or make this maybe look like it's an outdoor type of set. Maybe there's a pool out there or something crazy. We have tall windows with big industrial blinds. It's very easy to make these adjustments based on the light scale with the area light. Now let's try something a little bit different. We've talked about the way we can adjust a window. What about another type of texture? So we'll head back into our Gobo textures, back up to the root folder here. We'll head into abstract, and this is going to give us some really cool results. Bunch of lines, bunch of abstract shapes, and so on. Let's see what happens when we take the kind of rotating square texture that we have here in 31. We'll bring that right into our texture slot of our light. Holy cow. All right, so this is giving us a pretty interesting result here. This reminds me of a laser DJ show happening. We can get pretty cool with it. But playing with Gobos is super fun to do in Redshift. I like the way that they work exactly how you would expect them to without any major adjustment. One thing that I like to do is actually mix the lights. So for instance, we have our Gobo here that is making quite a bit of chaos in the scene. And maybe we'll drop our exposure down by -2 and we can place another light in the scene here. There we go. Either way, we can see what we're getting here. So the reason why I like to do this is because we can actually start to place a little bit more emphasis on the product by simply adding another light. So we can mix Gobo lights with lights in our environment. If we're light linking or anything of that nature, for instance, we can select our area light with the Gobos, head down to project, and then exclude our chair from this light. So now the Gobo lights is not affecting our chair at all, but we're still getting some really cool texture results just based off of the Gobos. So now our chair is being lit by the HDRI or the ambient lighting and our key light that we just placed in the scene. So this is a very cool way to mix them, use Gobos with standard clean lights and start to get some really cool results. All right, Gobo light textures, Cinema 4D and Redshift. They're super fun to play with. Now today we've talked about how to use them with a spotlight, how to use them with an area light, adjusting the spread, maybe feathering that Gobo just a little bit, various ways to change color temperature throughout the lights, and then how to balance a Gobo light with a regular, maybe key light, and how you can get some cool texture results in your scene. Now at CG Hacks, we have a cool pack of 150 different Gobo textures, links in the description if you're interested, and this is going to conclude today's video on Gobo light textures. So until the next one, create more, say less, and stay creative. I'll see you then.